A very good morning to the dear teachers and all my fellow friends. In this lovely morning, I am honored to deliver a speech entitled, If I was elected as the Prime Minister of Malaysia, what would I do to improve my country's economy in the presence of everyone today? The millennium is the era of globalization and age of modernization. It is really fascinating to see how things around us have advanced and still improving in all aspects in just a short span of time. The relentless engine of innovation is the wellspring of the nation's long-run prosperity. The advancement in science and technology has a great impact on the country's economic stability. The creativeness of the human brain is well reflected through the creation of technological gadgets. The progression from mechanical inventions and mathematical theories towards the modern concepts and machines formed a major academic field and the basis of a massive worldwide interest industry. Now, let us proceed with our discussion today. If I was elected as the future Prime Minister of Malaysia, I have several suggestions ringing at the back of my mind which will help to improve and enhance our country's economy to be on par with the first world countries. Ladies and gentlemen, in conjunction with our Prime Minister's slogan, One Malaysia, unity is one of the important aspects in nurturing our country's economy. Since we are living in a multiracial country, unity is crucial in order to maintain peace and tranquility of our beloved country. When our country is robbed of its unity, no development can be done, thus our economy will drop tremendously. I will enforce and implement the usage of English in both primary and secondary schools, since English is the global language. When people use the same language to communicate, there will not be any difficulties in interacting with each other, expressing their opinions and ideas, and English will also enable us to discuss and join hands with the other nations for mass projects that will upgrade our economy. In addition, by developing the country's infrastructures, facilities, telecommunications, and also building faster distribution routes, can make sure that the country's resources are more easily accessible, such as particular roads should be connected directly from the factories to the ports for shipping so that the goods can be transported without fail and there will not be any disturbance for the road users as well. This will attract the MDI. Do anyone of you know what is MDI? Let me tell you what is it. MDI is foreign direct investment. By attracting the MDI into the country, foreign companies can invest in local workers and help to train and educate the local labor force and hire them, thus creating employment and bringing in more money into the country's economy. Furthermore, I would enforce stringent law that will totally abolish corruption in our country. Money that is regarded from corruption is the one that leads our country's economy to drop progressively. If an individual is found to be guilty of committing the crime of taking or giving bribe, both parties should be sentenced to jail and should be given the heaviest punishment without considering their positions in the society. Corruptions are the main reason for the unsettled debts of our country in foreign nations. These debts will pose an obstacle to the growth and development of our country. Dear friends, last but not least, in addition to what I have stated earlier, I will be a responsible and a dedicated Prime Minister who will put my people's priority first to ensure the prosperity and longevity of our nation. Though other pillars are also crucial, economy is one of the main goals that is needed for the development of our country in the long run. Therefore, I would like to summarize my speech saying that you need two hands to clap. If I was the Prime Minister, my effort alone will not help. Cooperation and involvement from the people is important in establishing a prosperous and a successful nation. With this note, I end my speech. Thank you.